Hey guys, this is Kimmy Cookie. In this video, I'm doing another mythology related picture. But I should say right now that this is the second drawing I did of Nergal, the character in this video. And the reason for that is because my computer glitched out and I lost the recording for the first picture. The picture is done, but I lost the recording to it. I have no idea how it happened. And it's the first time it happened the way it did. So you'll be seeing two different pictures at the end of this video, not just one. And I hope you like them. As I said before, the character in this video, I am drawing Nergal, the god of plagues, who is also the husband of Ereshkigal. I did do a mythology video on Ereshkigal, so if you want to watch that video, I'll have the link to that video in the description box below. But more about Nergal. From my research online, he is not only the god of plagues, but he is also a solar god and a war god. His attributes as a solar god are, from what I understood, is the negative part of the sun, which is scorching the earth and very intense summer heat. And that sort of thing. I have also read that Nergal is also kind of the equivalent of the Greeks' god Ares, who is the god of war. So he's kind of a warlord, I guess. And, that's just something I read, so I don't know if it's correct or wrong or what. And about Nergal, he's also Ereshkigal's husband. There are some stories about how that came out. They all have their similarities and their differences. The first version I read was that Nergal wanted the throne of the underworld, so he took Ereshkigal, or he told Ereshkigal, who was already queen of the underworld at that time, that she either had to marry him or battle him, and in which he would be able to decapitate her because he was stronger than her. In other words, he got his spot as lord of the underworld by force. But I also read a version where Nergal had some kind of banquet party thing for the gods and invited the gods, but found out that Ereshkigal could not leave her post because it's part of her job to stay in the underworld at all times and govern it. So she sent her attendant instead. And Nergal did not really like the attendant and disrespected the attendant. How he disrespected the attendant, I have no idea. I couldn't really find that bit of information. I'm sure it's out there, but I couldn't find it. He disrespected it. The intendant and the other gods got upset about it, or mad, I don't know. They banished Nergal to Ereshkigal's land, and as time went on, he eventually married her. In other versions, Ereshkigal forced Nergal into marriage because he disrespected the intendant, and thus disrespected Ereshkigal's name and her image, herself. Like I said, there are lots of versions and stories about their marriage. A lot of people that wrote or put these stories online have also said that their stories are really a thing of romance or something like that. I kind of didn't really find those stories very romantic. I find them kind of creepy and weird. I don't know. But personally, in my opinion, it would make more sense if he forced his way to the throne, because he is a warlord god, a scorching sun god, and a pestilence god. He seems like he can be a destructive badass that you don't want to mess with. Yeah. I don't really have much to say about the design. He, in a way, from what I also understood, that he's kind of a pre-Islamic god. I don't know if that's, it's just one of the things I've read. And I've also read that he's also a desert god too. So some there's I kind of based his design a little bit like with the cloth over his face to keep the sun out and stuff. And since he's the god of plagues, his skin isn't perfect. Like, he has plague skin. And I was trying to make his skin tone darker, and I think I did a better job with that in the first picture than I did in the second picture. But overall, I really like how this character came out. His design. I really like it. I've also read that his weapon of choice is usually a mace or a hammer, but instead I gave him his weird gauntlet things. Because to me, he would seem more badass to me if he was able to continuously fight and kill with his own bare hands. I don't know. That's pretty much it. I actually had a lot of fun designing this character, like I did with Erish Kigel. I think if I am able to get myself to it, I would probably create a manga or something, or maybe write a story about it. About my own character designs. I don't know. But anyways, that is it. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you guys enjoy the rest of this video. And I hope you guys like the thing that I'm doing with mythology and stuff. Have a good weekend. Bye.